Hello everyone, this is Sumita Gupta. Welcome you all for my fourth lecture of Internet Communication Engineering, that is IPv4 2 level and 3 level addressing. So in IPv4, Internet Version Protocol 4, today we will learn 2 level addressing, 3 level addressing along with the network mask and subnet mask. Okay, so first of all, 2 level addressing. In 2 level addressing, first is network ID and second one is host ID. If you remember, for IPv4, the bits are fixed, that is total bits are 32 bits. And as I have already explained in the previous lecture, the classification of blocks, class A, class B, class C, in class A, N equals to 8 is fixed, means network ID 8 is fixed, then host ID will be 32 minus 8, that is 24. Now for class B, if it is 16, then 32 minus 16 is 16. So network ID will be 16 and host ID will be 16. For class C, it is 24, then it will be 8. That is for class C. So this is your network ID and host ID. Okay. Now remember, two-level addressing is like a phone number. Suppose a telephone number in the United States, the first is, this is your area code and this is your local code. So your area code will be like network ID. And the local code will be your like host ID. Okay, this is your two-level addressing. Now, for example, how to extract the information from the block? So remember, whatever small n given, so from that, by the expression of capital N equals to 2 raised to 32 minus n, you can find out number of addresses. Means how many addresses are in the block. Okay. Now, for finding the first address and the last address, remember, the small n bits are fixed and the next bits are 32 minus 10, that is your host ID. So the next bits, which are 32 minus n, initially all will be 0 in first address and the last all will be 1 for the last address. Remember this. Okay, see here. This is your for class A, 8, class B, 16, class C, 24. So first of all, remember the network ID depends on your class, okay? And the host ID, whatever your host ID, but it will start from 0 and end on 1. Means initial, means first address will be, in host ID all will be 0 and for last address all will be 1. Suppose, for example, this is your address, 7322-1725. And we have to find the number of addresses in the block. And what is the first address and what is the last address? Okay. Now, the first number is 73. And 73 is in the range of 0 to 127. And if you remember for class A, the range was from 0 to 127. So means this question is from class A. And for class A, small n is fixed, that is 8. For class A, small n is fixed 8. Means network ID is of 8 bits. The remaining 24 it will be your host ID. Okay. Now see here. Given address was 73.22.17.25. But initially in first address, all will be zeros. Okay. What I have explained you now, just now, remember, apart from network ID, rest will be zeros for the first address and rest will be ones for the last address. If all wins one, okay, see this 8 bit. So the first 8 bit is your network ID for class A, that is fixed. So remaining 8, 3 is 24. So all 24 bits are zeros. So 0.0.0. And all 24 bits are one, that will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 255. If you will convert in the decimal, it will 255. For next 8 also 255. For next 8 also 255. So in this way, your last address will be 73.255.255.255. Okay. Clear? Okay. So listen, this one, okay, network ID is fixed, network ID is fixed, but your host ID, the first address are zeros. And last address all one. Now, for example, this is the first and the last address. Now, the range will, after zero, this is one. It will start from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and it will end on 254, then 255. Right, this? So this is our class A example. As per how many total addresses are there, so in that expression is 2 raised to 32 minus n, and n is fixed, that is 8, so 2 raised to 24, this is your total addresses for this particular block. Okay, and how to find out the first address? For the addresses, all bits 0 apart from network ID, all bits 1 apart from the network ID. So this is the solution of exercise. Now pause the video for the second and now solve yourself. Have you solved this? The address is given, you have to find that the number of addresses, first address and last address, but the difference is everything is same, but in this place of 73 now it is 180. Now it is 180, and 180 is in the range of 128 to 191. If you remember, for class A, range was from 0 to 127, and for class B, range is from 128 to 191. So it is in the range of class B, and you know, for class B, network ID is fixed, and that network ID is 16. So now network ID is of 16 bits and host ID of 16 bits. And if you remember, network ID is fixed, but for host ID, starting bits all are zeros. All are zeros means all 16 bits are 0 bits. 8-8 combination, it will be 0.0. And all 16 bits are 1. It is a combination of 8 bits and 8 bits. First 8 bits 1 means 255. Then 8 bits means 255. So whatever the address, the first address, last two bits will be 0.0, and last two bits in the last digit is 255.255. So the given address 180.8.79, we will not touch first two combination, because you know this is 8 bit, this is 8 bit, this is 8 bit, this is 8. The first two combination of 16 bit, that is your network ID, that is fixed, we will not touch it. Next two combination are the part of host ID, but we want the first address. The first address, these two bits will be 0.0, and for last address, these two will be 255.255. Okay, last two bits will be 255.255. Again, listen, first of all, you have to check only this first number, that is 180, and 180 is a part of class B. In class B, network ID is fixed of 16 bits. And you know total bits of 32. It is a combination of 8, 8, 8, 8. So for class B, first two bits are fixed. We will not touch it. So first two, 180.8 is fixed. And last two, all will be 0 in the first address. And all zero bits will be 1 for the last address. So first address will be 180.8.0.0. And the last address will be 180.8.255.255. Okay. So this is your first address and last address. Okay. Now in between, after 0, 1, 1, then 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So both will be, this last bit will be 1, 2, 254. Because 0 to 255. 1 to 254, then 255. Now next is 0, 0, next also up to 255, like this. Okay, so this is your class B. Now, total number of addresses 2 raised to 32 minus n, and 2 raised to 32 minus 60 is 2 raised to 16, that is 65536. Now, again, the same example. Pause the video for a second, for the minute, and solve this. Only the difference of classes, only that's it, and the rest is same. Okay, now 200 is a part of class right C, and how many bits are in C? Very good, it is 24. So now network ID is of 24 and host ID is of 8 bit. Okay, 24 means 888, means first three are fixed. First three are fixed, because 8 to the 16 to the 30, 8 to the 24. So last 8 bits starting all will be zeros, and last all will be 1 means 255. What is your starting address? Starting address will be 200.11.8.0 and last address 200, very good, dot 11, right, a dot 8 dot 255, very good. Okay, so this is your first address and last address, and the number of addresses 2 raised to 32 minus n means 2 raised to 32 minus 24, it is 256. Okay, so see this, first address 0, last address 255, and these are the middle address, means it will be this number will be 1 to 254, and then this number is, and the rest is same. Rest 211.8 is a network ID, that is same in October. Only this number will be 1 to 254. Okay, here it is 0 to 55, here it is 1 to 250. Okay, so now we have done the three examples, one for class A, one for class B, one for class C. So now it is very easy to, for you to calculate the number of addresses, first address and the last address. Okay, now next is the concept of network mask or default mask. See that what happened, the routers in the internet, they just use an algorithm to find the exact address or exact packets. So for that, they use network mask. Means whenever you want to identify something, you want some identification mask. So network mask or default mask helps the router to find the exactly network address. See how. See, this is your class A, class B, class C. As I have already explained you, in class A, 8 bits is your network ID, rest is your host ID. Class B, 16 bits is your network ID, rest is your host ID. In class C, 24 bits are your network ID and the rest 8 bits are your host ID. So see, the whatever network ID, it will be 1 and rest will be zeros. So for class A, what is your network mask? 255.0.0.0. For class B, 255.255.0.0. For class C, 255.255.255.0. Okay. So now the question is, if network mask is there, then how to find the network address? Okay. So see, you are having the destination address, right? And you are having the default mask or network mask, that is your identification mask. Just adding both of that, then you will find the network address, that this is your network address. So how? We'll do by one example. Okay. So now see the exercise. All the examples I have taken the book frozen. Okay. A router receives a packet with a destination address. Means see, this is 201.24.16.32 is your destination address. Okay. Means we router receives a packet and the destination address is this. But now router doesn't know what is the network address. That want to know the network address, then how he will find the network address. Okay, so first of all you should know what is the default mask. For default mask, it is necessary to find the class. Now 201 is a part of class C, and for class C, what is the network mask? It's a class C or class B. 201 is the class, a part of class B. Okay, so class B is your default mask. Now destination address is given 201.24.67.32 and your default mask is 255.255.0.0. just adding it. Now shortcut is 255 is like 255 is like 1. Now something is multiplied by 1 is same. Something is multiplied by 1 is same. Something is multiplied by 0 is 0, 0. So now by default mask, it is clear the network address was 201.224.0.0.0. So what you have to do, you have to just check what is the default mask. Okay. Now three-level addressing. Sometimes two-level addressing is somewhat difficult, complex. So we have again divided the network into sub-network. That is called your subnet. See, for this example, this is a telephone number. This was your area code. This is your exchange code. Suppose there is subscriber connection also, apart from the exchange code. This is your the type of 1, 2, 3-level addressing. now, okay, if subnetting is there, then subnet mask is also there, like a network mask. Okay, see, this is your router, this is your whole combined one network, 141.14.0.0. okay, but this network is divided in four parts: subnet 1, subnet 2, subnet 3, subnet. In all subnet, there is some default mask, that is your subnetting mask. Okay, so like network mask has network ID, host ID, as the same way subnet mask is also having subnet ID and host ID. Okay, but these are different of bits. Here in network mask, net ID is different. Here in subnet mask, subnet mask ID is also different. ID means number of bits also changes. Okay, so subnetting, number of subnetting mask, it is calculated by this formula: n sub equals to small n plus log base 2 s. S is your number of sub network, and okay, and n is your length of network ID, actual network ID. And S is number of subnetwork, then this answer means subnetwork ID you will find out by this expression. Okay, subnet ID for each subnetwork. Okay, for example, suppose a small n is 16 and we want to divide it in four subnet masks. Okay, so what is the formula here? Is small n plus log base 2 S. Okay, so what is a small n given? That is given 16, okay, plus log base 2, and we want to divide it in how many parts? Four parts. So it is in four parts. Okay, so it will comes 2. So 16 plus 2 is 18. So in sub network, your network ID is 16, but in actually network, the network ID was in sub network, network ID is 18. But in network ID, it was 16 only. So now it is increased by 2 bits. Here, listen. In network ID, for this example, it was 16. But now it increases by 2. It becomes 18. Understood? So this is your subnet ID. Okay? So we have learned 2-level and 3-level addressing. Keep learning, keep sharing. If you have any doubt, you can write in comment box. God bless you. Thank you.